name is Dr. Esther Trufan, and in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to make a 1 molar hydrochloric acid solution using deionized water and concentrated hydrochloric acid. The concentrated hydrochloric acid solution's molarity varies quite a bit, and because we never know what is the original starting concentration, we only know an estimate of it, it is always important that after we complete the dilution experiment, we have to standardize the hydrochloric acid solution to confirm how close or how far we got from the originally intended 1 molar concentration. So let's get started. The first thing that we're going to need is a volumetric flask, because one should never make a solution in any other container than a volumetric flask. For today's experiment, we're making 100 milliliters of solution. So we will need a 100 milliliter volumetric flask. We're going to need some hydrochloric acid and some deionized water. We need to know the exact volume of concentrated hydrochloric acid that we're using, so we will need a 10 milliliter graduated cylinder. And because we will be pipetting material out of our concentrated hydrochloric acid container, we will need to first transfer it into a beaker, and then using a pipette with a bulb, we will need to make the transfers. The dilution of concentrated acid usually produces a substantial amount of heat, and to contain that heat and not allow our solution to overheat, we want to perform this dilution in an ice water bath. Now that we have all our equipment and materials, let's get started with the process. The first thing we're going to do is fill about halfway our volumetric flask with deionized water. We can always use a 50 milliliter graduated cylinder to do a more accurate volume addition, but we can just eyeball it. We can put the cap back in so it does not get contaminated, and then transfer our volumetric flask inside our ice bath. The next thing is measuring out the amount of concentrated hydrochloric acid that we're using. We will need 8.47 milliliters. And so for that, we will use a 10 milliliter graduated cylinder and a beaker from which the transfer will occur. Working with concentrated acids always has to be done in a fume hood. And if you ever attempt otherwise, the smell will let you know that it's time to move to a fume hood. If you're close to the desired amount, it is always best to transition to using a pipette. I am done with measuring out 8.47 milliliters of concentrated hydrochloric acid, and now I can add it to my volumetric flask that has the water in it. The addition should be done in small increments. And every addition should be followed by some vigorous swirling to make sure that the solution is homogeneous. The temperature of my volumetric flask is quite reasonable because I have been keeping it in the ice water bath. Any additional additions of water will not change the temperature by much. So at this point, I can set my ice bath to the side. Next, I want to ensure that all my hydrochloric acid has transferred. So I will add a small increment of deionized water into the graduated cylinder. It can be as small as you want it, and it could be as much as 10 milliliters. And we do this at least twice. At this point, we can consider all our hydrochloric acid successfully transferred into the volumetric flask. So the solute is where it needs to be. The final volume of the solution is yet unknown. The only volume marker on a volumetric flask is this ring towards the middle of the neck. And that says when our volume hits that mark, it is exactly 100 milliliters. And we always want to get the meniscus of the solution to be at the marking. So the next thing that we do is simply add water. Add a little bit of water, swirl it, and then when we get close to the neck, we can add a little bit more, but definitely slow it down. And when we get close to the marking, then we switch to a pipette to get the meniscus exactly at the marking. At this point, swirling becomes extremely difficult. And we are close enough to the neck to transition to a pipette. From here, our water and our concentrated hydrochloric acid solution can be disposed of. We have the right amount of solute and the right volume of solution inside our volumetric flask. The only thing that's missing is for this solution to be homogeneous. And for that, we're going to place the cap on top and then move it side to side, up and down, about 3 to 5 times. And when we are done with this, we can put it down and consider our solution to be approximately 1 molar for the hydrochloric acid solution that we made. Again, it is important that we understand we intended to make a 1 molar hydrochloric acid solution, and we did everything that we could to get it there. But because the original concentration of the concentrated hydrochloric acid is a range and not an actual number, our value could also be on a range, and we have to standardize it before we can say anything concrete about the exact concentration of the solution. But it should be around 1 molar. Thank you.